All right, what's up, Cowboys Nation? Making this video reluctantly. When I say reluctantly, I mean I'd rather be doing what you guys like to see me doing, which is breaking down film on our players and other players around the league. I have fun doing what I do. Let me just put that out there. Let me dispel a couple of notions and rumors as well. One being that I'm jealous or in some way trying to steal viewers from the great Mark Holmes. I am not. I don't pay any attention to Mark Holmes when it comes to his subscribers. I know he has 20,000 or more. I have about 7,000 and counting, and I've been doing this for a couple months. So I'm not in any way jealous, nor am I, you know, trying to tear anyone down on my way up. I don't think that way. I believe in karma. So I just wouldn't do anything like that. Just let me put that out there first. Number two, you know, shout out to everybody who does this because it takes time and effort to be a content creator in any medium. Trust me, I know. But shout out Mark Holmes. Shout out Law Nation. Vosh Lombardi, that's my man. I learned a lot from him, believe it or not. Foots the King. Sola. Bang With You Heavy. Dallas Cowboy Scouting, our West Coast Cowboy, man. You know you guys. You know, Big Game James. JoJo, you know, all you guys out there that make content, Space Cowboy, my man Game Changer, X Factor, you know, all you guys out there that make content, trust me, I don't think that I'm better than anyone. I don't think I'm better than any of you. I have a different purview and a different perspective, and I bring that. That's my value, because no one can be better at being you than you. So you guys bring your own perspectives, and that's what makes this whole fan base great. We all have a very diverse backgrounds, but that's why I love football in the first place. It's the one true team sport where you have to, one, be a real man about it. You can't hide that. It's not flag football. You get hit in the mouth, you got to get up, take it, keep coming. That's one. Two is people from diverse backgrounds and nationalities, races, creeds, sizes and shapes, speeds, everything, you know, orientations, whatever, that have to come together and work together for a common good. I respect that about football. Now, moving forward into the whole series of events that transpired today, or that's still transpiring, Mark Holmes and I, let me tell you, and I'm talking to both you, Mark Holmes, and the Cowboy Nation, and anyone else who watches, I will say it for the last time. I don't have a personal problem with Mark Holmes. Not a personal problem with Mark Holmes. I don't have a professional problem with Mark Holmes, okay? Nor do I mention Mark Holmes in anything that I do, unless I'm mentioned first. So if you've ever seen me say anything, do know I'm not a bully. I'm not coming to attack him. And if you won't do the research to go out and see what would cause me to say anything about Mark Holmes, then you don't care anyway. You're just looking for something to say or some controversy, and then I don't really care to talk or address you. But those of you who think that I just came out maliciously at Mark Holmes, you're crazy. There's nothing malicious about my intentions with that video. Everything that I put together was to be funny. I had a good time making it. I don't regret making it because I know what my intentions were at the end of the day. Now, word has gotten back to me that, you know, it has drawn some offense on his end. And I saw his video. So, you know, I know where I can shove it. And that doesn't bother me. I'm not the type of person to truly beef with someone whom I've never met. So I don't have a personal problem with you. If I saw you today, I wouldn't put my hands up. I would shake your hand. I would sit down, get drunk with you. I would talk to you and your son. And that would be that. You know, and I let you say whatever you got to say, because I don't look at you as a threat, nor do I look at you like a person who wants to cause me any type of financial or bodily harm. So you're not my enemy. We both root for the same team. As far as people thinking that I think that you're a bandwagon hopper, wasn't really the best laid out parody, but it's parody, man. It's meant to be funny. I wasn't talking about you truly being a bandwagon hopper. I will only say that if you're wearing a Washington Redskins jersey. Do I agree with tanking for a season? That's something that we're going to disagree on. I know what you meant. I know you meant well, but at that time during the season, like we weren't out of the playoff running, so I don't agree with tanking at all, even if you are. But unless you're just like already, you know, 1 in 10, and okay, well, that would make sense then. We weren't in that type of predicament. So, you know, for me to say I don't understand where they do that at, that's what I was referring to. But for the rest of the video, the rest of the video that's like aligning up the ideas that you spoke on about Dez, that wasn't nitpicking. The fact that you were speaking positively about Dez was just let me show you that, hey, you had some affinity for the same guy at some point. So don't judge me and make me the Dez apologist when you decide to change your mind. That doesn't make much sense. If you and I are going to the left and you say, hey, I want to go right, you don't say you're a leftist. You just go to the right. That's cool. Do what you do. But when you went to the other side and said you no longer like Dez, which is your right to do, I somehow became the target of comments and content. I mean, I never asked for any of that. I honestly don't care to debate unless we're going to talk about things that are factual, not emotional. Now, if you want to talk about facts, we can do that. And if you still draw up the conclusion that Dez is washed up, I would disagree with you. If you say Dez is not what he used to be, I'm not what I used to be. I don't say that Dez is, you know, still the Dez of 2013. I never said that. Injuries would tell you that. He hasn't made it through a full season without getting injured yet in the last 3 years. So would I say that Dez is the same as he was in 2013? No. But would I say that Dez is the sole reason that we have issues on this team? That's all I say. He's not the guilty party where he's the cancer in the locker room or on the team and are the reason that we're not winning. And it's common sense would tell you, and we can talk about this live, face-to-face, or we could talk about it now, but if I say what came first, the chicken or the egg, right? You would say, okay, I don't know, right? It's a conundrum. We can go back and forth about that. But that proverbial question sort of plays in, is not necessary and doesn't play into the NFL. The reason I say that is, you know, if the entire offense is stagnated, the receiving core, you know, the entire receiving core is stagnated, there is no way you can tell me just through attrition, all of them just became old overnight and mediocre overnight, including Dez. Not all of them. There has to be something bigger to play into that, right? Like if you have a farm and one chick dies, okay, he could have just been sick. But if you come into the barn or the hen house and they're all dead, you're not going to say they were sick. You're going to say, well, what? Who killed them? You know what I mean? That's the same thing I said, just using Dez as the main point of focus about our receiving corps and about Dak. That's not me being a Dez apologist. That's not me being a Dak hater. That's me saying, hey, if all of the receivers are going down in numbers, after one particular player takes over the helm, that has to mean something. Either the coaching staff is flawed, someone was injured, or the quarterback had inept ability to adjust to the circumstances he was placed in. And I say, or the receivers weren't doing their job, but I say it's a combination of all four, not one player. The nation makes it seem like it's one player. My defense of Dez, though, and the passion in my defense doesn't come from the fact that I love Dez. It comes from the fact that, yo, when I look, I respect loyalty. If you were cool with your son, Law, I'm not talking about Law, I'm sorry, Mark, and then somehow you became successful at this and you said, I would never do another video with him, I would say you're disloyal, you know, and I wouldn't respect you, right? So if Dez, you know, played the way he played for us, well, no matter what you tried to say about him, if you're going to cut him, just like we cut DeMarcus Ware, I didn't care. Jason Witten just retired. I didn't like it, but okay, it happened. Tony Romo retired. It happened. The way they transitioned Romo out, they didn't kick him in the ass on the way and say, he sucks, Dak's better, let's let Dak play. I would have defended Romo then. You know what I mean? If you would have took Jason Witten and said, he needs to retire, he can't get open, and then I look at film saying he's open and he's not getting the ball, I would be defending Witten because you're attacking the man who played well for the star. That's my defense of Dez. He played his heart out for the star. So on his way out, let him leave gracefully. Let him leave gracefully and let him leave with a shot. So my issue was that. And when people were talking about him taking a pay cut, you never heard me say Dez shouldn't restructure his contract. When you say Dez didn't earn his contract, okay, I'm going to argue with you because he earned it. Yeah, he did, definitely. If you say you want to restructure it so that, you know, the team could perform better fiscally, who's going to argue with that? I'm a Cowboy fan, okay? I want the team to do better. I want them to bring players in that cost a pretty penny if they have to, right? So I'm going on and on, but all I'm saying is this. Don't have a personal problem with Mark or his son or anyone that does YouTube videos. I respect you. If you want to talk, I'm willing to talk tonight because I don't want to drag this on into another day, another week, another hour. I just want to get it over with. Let's talk. You know, let's get on live somewhere so that we don't have to be scripted. People know we're not, you know, sitting there reading. And, you know, let's talk tonight. So call Law. I'll call him. He can be the little referee or the mediator or moderator. And we can talk, man. And from then on, you know, you go do your thing. You make your videos. I'll make mine. I see you in traffic. I say what up. You know, you see me, say what up. I got nothing but respect for what y'all do over there. And again, people, keep in mind, I never mentioned Mark Holmes until Mark Holmes mentions me. I don't say anything at all about anybody until people say something about me. If you say, hey, he can say shots fired, and that's mature, and I'm okay with it. And then he says, hey, when we play debunks Akoye, and people go on there and say, hey, hoorah, Akoye, don't know what the hell he's talking about, but that's okay. But then when I go and talk about Mark, it's not okay. What type of shit is that? You know, that's not fair, nor is it like in the realm of reason. There's people on my page talking about I'm despicable for defending myself. It's despicable not to. If I sit here and I let you, I'm not a turn of a cheek guy, man. And that's one thing I want to say about who I am. I'm articulate. I am educated. I like to think I'm smart. Sometimes I do dumb shit. But at the same time, I'm a kid from the projects, man. Where I come from, people are a little rougher. I played football too. We were rough. Football, listen to the, if people let you listen to what people say to each other, what Brady says to his players on the sideline, it's not nice. So just because I'm not nice doesn't mean I don't like you or hate you or some shit. I'm not a nice person all the time. Sometimes I have a fucked up sense of humor. Sometimes I'm funny. Sometimes I'm not so funny. But if you didn't like it, don't think that it came from a place of malice. I literally was laughing out loud. And a lot of people on my page were cracking the fuck up at the video. I thought Mark would not like it, but I thought he would laugh at it, honestly. Because if he'd have put it out there like that at me, I'd have said, okay, touche. Now I'm going to get in the lab and get right back at you. I come at Law Nation all the time. You know what he say? I'm about to go get in the lab. And he come right back at me. I don't ever get mad at that because that drives the culture. That's all it is. I want you to try to put your best film forward because that makes the Cowboy Nation stronger. I'm going to put my best film forward. If we're all just saying kumbaya, let's all be friends. Let's all just believe the same things. Let's all love each other. I got love for everybody. But when I say love each other, I mean, let's all just love each other's content and say, you know, that's not, there's no contrast there. There's contrast here because I don't agree all the time with you. You're not going to all the time agree with me. But when we come together and we debate, if we're not debating on an emotional scale, then at some point that common ground has to prevail. And I only debate with facts. That's why I prove it with the film. Now, people who say that I go and cherry pick to support a narrative, you make zero sense, okay? If I say Darius likes to wear black shirts, my name's Darius. People like to say Darius likes to wear black shirts, and I go and find nothing but film with Darius with black shirts from year 2018, and I put that out there, I'm trying to prove a point statistically. So you isolate the instances that you're trying to prove. That is the whole point in creating film. You don't say, hey, a guy can't block and then go look for film of him blocking well only. You go find both to create contrast, and then you give the person who's watching the ability to decide. All I do with my videos, with Dak, if you say that I hated on Dak, didn't. I made a video initially. One's called 1 Year Wonder question mark, and that video talks about the impact of Romo, the Dak 2016 season, how well he played, the offensive line, the inept coaching. And then I did a second video that said no excuses, saying these are the things you need to improve on, because now Dez is gone like you want it, like the team want it, and now there's pressure going to be on Dak. So now there are no excuses. Now, to me saying that, I thought that was obvious, but I guess it's not, right? But I said it anyway. So anyone who has an issue or takes issue or offense to what I say, please toughen up, man. Because I'm not a guy that's out. Like, if you, any of you saw me out at a bar, I'd shake your hand, buy you a drink, say, let's talk Cowboys, man. I don't care. Like, and I got footage of me down in at the draft. You know, I was with the Hitters. Shout out to the Hitters, man. You guys had weird hospitality, but y'all some thorough people, man. Thorough. So, like I said, I was with them, and, you know, they a wild, rowdy bunch. But I had fun. Shout out to Barry Gibson doing those articles that you did, man. Like, I appreciate everybody in the game, man. Shout out to Miss Price. I got the pleasure of meeting her at Boston's, man, at an event that we did. JoJo, I think I said that. But, again, Law, talk to your boy. Talk to your boy, Mark. Get him on the line. Let's do a show or something tonight and get this over with, man, because, you know, I'm eager. I'm not coming prepared with anything. I'll come and sit down and just talk off the top. Let's go.